Welcome to Evolve Science X, the channel where we merge cutting-edge science with real-life strategies to unlock human potential. I'm Sunita, and today, we're diving deep into one of the most powerful forces shaping your success discipline. You've probably set goals before, to eat clean, hit the gym, quit a habit, build a business, or finally finish that project. And yet, somehow, life gets in the way. Why do our best intentions fall apart? Why do we say, I'll start tomorrow, and then never do? In this episode, we'll explore the science of self-control, willpower, and focus. You'll learn how discipline rewires your brain, why willpower fails and how to train it, the psychology behind failed goals, and how to create laser focus by eliminating distractions and protecting your energy. We'll break it all down in chapters backed by neuroscience, psychology, and tools used by elite performers, monks, and entrepreneurs around the world. This isn't about hustling harder. It's about becoming the kind of person who follows through, not because it's easy, but because you've trained your mind like a muscle. So grab a pen, take a breath, and let's rebuild the blueprint of your life from the inside out. This is Evolve Science X, and you're about to become unstoppable. The psychology of discipline isn't punishment. It's a framework, an invisible scaffolding that keeps our goals upright when motivation collapses. Psychologists define discipline as self-regulated behavior in pursuit of a valued aim. Key brain region? The prefrontal cortex, our inner CEO, tasked with decision-making, impulse control, and future planning. Picture the famous marshmallow experiment. Kids offered a marshmallow now or two later. Those who waited grew into adults with higher SAT scores and better health. Lesson: delayed gratification is the seed of lifelong success. Repeat after me. Discipline is the bridge between goals and accomplishment. Without that bridge, dreams remain mirages, the neuroscience of willpower. Enter willpower, the battery that fuels discipline. Florida State psychologist Roy Baumeister calls it a finite resource. Decisions, stress, lack of sleep all drain the battery. That crash you feel at 11 p.m.? Prefrontal cortex glucose depleted. But here's the twist. Willpower is trainable. Every time you resist scrolling, every mindful breath in meditation, you're upgrading neural circuits in the anterior cingulate cortex, boosting self-control. Think of it like muscular hypertrophy, but for restraint. Quick hack. Maintain stable blood glucose with balanced meals. Low sugar equals low willpower. Fuel the brain. Protect the battery. Why goals fail? The American Psychological Association's Stress in America survey has a clear villain: lack of willpower. Yet Baumeister's research shows three missing links. Motivation, a why so compelling it hurts to quit. Monitoring, real-time feedback. What gets measured gets managed. Willpower, the execution engine. Most people skip the first two, then blame the third. They live in reaction mode, not intention mode. Remember, systems beat feelings. You don't rise to your goals. You fall to your systems. Training self-control and willpower. Ready for science-backed drills? Grab a notebook. Set SMART goals. Specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, time-bound. Implementation intentions. If it's 6 a.m., then I put on running shoes. This simple cue-action pair can double follow-through rates. Daily discomfort reps. Cold shower stairs over elevator 5 extra push-ups. Each micro-challenge thickens your willpower fibers. Mindfulness. 10 minutes of breath work cuts mind-wandering by almost half in lab studies, and enlarges gray matter in self-control regions. 20-second rule. Increase friction to bad habits by 20 seconds. Unplug the TV stash cookies in the attic. Willpower conserved is willpower earned. Repeat these drills for just 6 weeks, and MRI scans show measurable prefrontal upgrades. Focus, elimination, and the silent power of goals. Focus is subtraction, not addition. 80-20. Rule, 20% of actions deliver 80% of results. Find your 20. Guard it ruthlessly. Guard your energy. Here's a controversial truth. Sometimes you must keep your goals silent. Sharing big dreams too early triggers a dopamine hit that mimics accomplishment, killing urgency. Worse, friends and family might project fear or envy. Be realistic. Their doubt seeps into your subconscious. Cultures call it the evil eye. Jealous energy that spoils fortune. Whether mystical or psychological, the effect is real. Negative social feedback reduces persistence in experimental tasks. So treat your ambitions like delicate seedlings. Protect them from frost. Work in silence. Let success be the noise. Your mind is a castle. Envy doesn't get a key. Practical step. Keep a private goal journal. Track progress, not opinions. Discipline in student life and beyond. Students, listen up. Discipline today is compound interest tomorrow. Study schedules prevent last-minute cortisol spikes, guard mental health, and build identity. I'm the kind of person who shows up. Athletes periodize training. Scientists run protocols. CEOs time block calendars. Same principle. Ordered effort defeats chaos. A disciplined body and mind survive setbacks, exams, layoffs, heartbreak. Because routine is the life raft. Mindset determines destiny. Stanford's Carol Dweck coined the growth mindset, belief that abilities evolve through effort. Discipline is the practice ground. Each rep whispers, I can change. Stack mindset, discipline, and laser focus, and you become unstoppable. Remember, motivation starts the race. Discipline finishes it. Action, even tiny two-minute action, cements habit circuits. Your future self isn't luck. It's algorithm. Today's discipline choices, tomorrow's reality. Discipline is hard, but regret is harder. Let's be real for a moment. Discipline is not easy. Some days you'll be exhausted. Your body will ache. Your mind will scream for comfort. You'll want to quit. And yes, discipline can feel like pain. But here's what they don't tell you. The pain of staying disciplined is temporary. The pain of regret? That lasts a lifetime. When you skip your dream, when you hit snooze on your potential, that pain doesn't go away. It follows you. It whispers when you're alone. It haunts you every time you see someone else doing what you were meant to do. So when you feel like quitting, don't say, it's hard. Don't say, it's painful. Don't you dare say, it's impossible. Burn this into your mind. There's no such thing as, I can't. Only, I will. Only, I must. Only, not yet, but soon. Because every time you keep going when it hurts, you train your brain to win, not to whine. Today's discipline choices, tomorrow's reality. If this episode sparked a fire, don't wait for a perfect Monday. Pick one drill. Time block your top task. Meditate 5 minutes or lock your phone in a drawer and do it now. Then come back tomorrow and do it again. Momentum loves repetition. Sophie's story, Don't Let Them Steal Your Dream, a story about a woman named Sophie. Since she was a little girl, Sophie dreamed of becoming a dentist. She loved the idea of healing people, of seeing their smiles restored. She knew deep in her soul that she was born to be a doctor. But her family didn't believe in her. They laughed. They told her, "You'll never be a dentist. You'll kill someone. You're not smart enough. You're not science-minded." And after hearing it for so long, Sophie believed them. She gave up. She worked physical jobs, sewing, gardening, day after day. But the dream never truly left. It whispered to her, even as the world around her grew louder. And while her cousins became surgeons, gynecologists, and dentists, Sophie stayed silent, because they all said, "You? You can't do it." Then, one day, Sophie traveled abroad. And at a small seminar, a spiritual teacher looked her in the eye and said, "Never let others tell you who you are. Their perception is not your destiny." Something clicked. Sophie, at 40 years old, enrolled in training. She studied. She failed. She got back up. And guess what? Today, Sophie is a practicing dentist. Not because she was special, but because she stopped listening to people who weren't qualified to define her future. What's the lesson? Never tell others your dreams. Protect them. If someone else couldn't do it, that doesn't mean you can't. Act in silence. Let success make the noise. Your mind is your castle. Don't let envy, doubt. This is Evolve Science X. Subscribe, share this with one friend who needs a discipline boost. And as always, evolve, don't revolve.